Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So recently with all of the Teletoon drama, that has kind of consumed the entire community, but luckily that seems to be kind of dying down. So we're going to go back to top 5 scenes of every season. Last time on Monday, I believe, we did top 5 scenes of the pilots. Now we are going to go ahead and continue with top 5 favorite scenes of season 1. So yeah, sit back and relax and enjoy the video. So in 5th place, we have Garmadon Destroys the Devourer, which is a very short scene that's less than a minute, but it is a pretty great scene nonetheless. One thing I really love about the scene was the music. It's just very ominous, and it's really nice music that fits with the scene very nicely. I also love the idea of Garmadon biting back, and of course, the Devourer was the one that turned him evil, and I think Garmadon being the one to destroy the Devourer was a great idea that it fits with that whole vengeance thing. And this scene is just amazing. Really shows how great of a character Garmadon is, and how cool he could be also, when he pretty much just jumps headfirst off of a pretty tall building and kills the Devourer. So yeah, that is a pretty good scene, and I definitely like how it shows how, you know, how brave Garmadon is and how cool Garmadon is. And yeah, the music supplements this very nicely. In 4th place, we have a flashback scene, which is Wu's flashback and story in Episode 7, A Tale of Two Brothers, I'm titling it, which explains how Garmadon turned evil and what his connection to the Great Devourer is. This scene is just, this story is just very chilling and really haunting for the most part, which is why it's so awesome. It starts out with the brothers just being very friendly, and you really do get to feel the love that they had for one another and that strong relationship that they had. But that soon collapses when Garmadon is bitten by the Devourer. I think it was great that we actually got to see an animated version of this happening, and what happens after is even better. It pretty much shows Garmadon explaining that he hates Wu and lashing out at Wu, which is amazing. I thought that was very haunting and, again, very chilling. And this was an amazing scene because it really did show how Garmadon was affected by the bite. Entering our top 3, we have the Green Ninja reveal, which I think was a really good scene. And again, one of the best parts of this scene was that they actually had Garmadon along with them, which made the scene all the more better. I thought it was really cool how every ninja just all of a sudden realized that Lloyd was the Green Ninja and they extended their weapons to him. And I thought that was very nicely done, how especially Kai, who he had already known that Lloyd was the Green Ninja after saving him from the volcano. But yeah, again, this scene really was, it really did sow the seeds for what would come between Lloyd and Garmadon later, and we kind of got a hint as to what would happen. I thought it was really sad when, you know, Wu explains that first brother versus brother, and now father versus son. And yeah, it really does explain the divisions of that family, and I thought having Garmadon there and Wu to explain it all really did make the scene a lot better. As for the plot twist itself, wasn't the best plot twist, kind of was predictable, but the scene itself was done very nicely. It just felt like a great scene, and it really was one of the big turning points in the first season. In second place, we have the Awakening the Devourer scene, which is where the intro music of this video came from. This scene is just amazing, and it is a pretty long scene as well, which I think was a great idea. This scene does kind of drag out a bit, and it is longer than it does have to be. But this was a good idea for the most part, because we got one scene where Pythor was just there alone, but then the ninja and Wu came as well. This scene was great for Wu as well, because it did hint at what would come in the next episode, as well as beautifully setting up the season finale for Rise of the Snakes. This scene also highlighted how much of a maniac Pythor is, and how silly he is to not have realized that the Great Devourer would destroy everything. This plot twist is also a decent twist as well, as the Great Devourer wouldn't actually be controlled by the Serpentine, but would actually destroy everything, including the Serpentine. The music is just very ominous and very chilling, and it is an amazing soundtrack as well. I think the music just really helps it, and it's, you know, one of the reasons why it's good that the scene is kind of longer is because of the soundtrack. The soundtrack, as well as longer, starts off kind of softer with slower parts, but then it grows to get a little bit more action-packed, and soon the ninja arriving there as well as Wu is really cool as well. I loved Wu actually having to, you know, restrain Pythor and keep him there. The idea of the green mist rising around, the ground collapsing right underneath their feet, and of course the Devourer stirring around right underneath them with its pink eyes visible, just made the scene all the more scarier. And I think that's what's great about the scene. It really did capture the horror of the Great Devourer, while also explaining how Wu is very noble, and how he is definitely a wise warrior as well. I absolutely love this scene. Zane's flashbacks in Episode 7 are among my favorite scenes in the entire series, and this episode as well is definitely my favorite of the season. This flashback, especially, has amazing soundtrack. This soundtrack is just wonderful. It is among my top 10 favorite soundtracks, and this is actually the original version of Zane's death soundtrack as well. As for the scene itself, it is an amazing scene that reminds us all of happier times, and also explains the loving relationship between Zane and his father. It also explains the story of a presumably lonely man who built himself a robot, and it was the son he never had. Unfortunately, that is all destroyed by what is assumed to be his passing, although later we learned that that is not actually the case, and Zane is just left to decide what to do with himself. And that is where we see a lot of the emotion kind of tug at our heartstrings, especially when Zane himself starts crying afterwards, despite learning that he is a robot. So yeah, I'm not really sure why he's crying if he's a robot. But yeah, anyways, this scene is just amazing because along with the soundtrack as well, it starts off very cheery and kind of happy at the beginning, but soon grows sad and slower at the end where the piano starts to kick in as Dr. Julian passes away. To me, this scene will always portray the perfect relationship between a son and his father. Starting out happy and remaining happy, a great strong relationship throughout its entire life, until of course the elder dies, and that really does take a toll on the child, leading him to wonder what his purpose in life is. This scene is just amazing, and to me it'll always be one of the best scenes in Ninjago. So yeah, that's going to be all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, share it with everyone you know, and let me know what you guys thought of my rankings, as well as listing your own top 5 scenes of Season 1 Rise of the Snakes down in the comment section below. Once again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.